As a student, myself, Adil Mishan Sheikh, Assistant Professor, Automobile Department, LJID. As we had a discussion regarding engine downsizing in previous lecture, and we have also discussion regarding basic factors of the stages of SI engines as well as CI engines, right? So today we are going to discuss about further engine downsizing and its importance in SI and CI engines. In previous lecture, we had a discussion regarding stages of SI engines as well as CI engines. Then we had a further discussion regarding attention of the spray guided system. So which are the basic factors of the spray guided system? We had already discussed in previous lecture. See, these are mainly six factors of the spray guided systems. And today we are going to discuss about engine downsizing. And we had already discussion. We had already discussed in previous session regarding basic introductory session of engine downsizing. So let us discuss further engine downsizing. See, many manufacturers recommended turbocharged engines as well as supercharged engines to get engine downsizing properly. Why turbocharged engine and supercharged engines helpful in engine downsizing? Because turbocharged engines and supercharged engine gives high density power output compared to the naturally aspirated engines. This is the main factors which we are going to use turbocharged and supercharged in SI engines. Anyhow, supercharged usage nowadays is very less compared to turbocharged, because supercharged consume power from the engine directly and it will be affected directly to the engine output. So nowadays we are using only turbocharged engine in SI engines. VW, Daimler Group also used turbocharged body in SI engines, and VW already had launch of TSI body, turbocharged stratified injection body, in commercial market, and it is running very successfully in our commercial automobile market. So with the help of turbocharged and supercharged, we can get engine downsized engines. And most important thing in engine downsizing is its direct injection process. See, we had already discussion regarding carburetor body, APFI body and DI body, right? So mainly direct injection body play an important role in downsized engine. With the help of direct injection system, we can get more pressure compared to the conventional engine, and we can also get high range of pressure in direct injection system compared to the conventional automobile engines. And we can say that with the help of this range of direct injection, we can reduce the number of cylinder in SI engines as well as CI engines. So I can say that if we are using 4-cylinder engines in 2000 era, but nowadays for same capacity engine we are using 3-cylinder engines. I can give you example of in around 2001 or 2002, we are using 4-cylinder engines up to 1200 cc capacity. Nowadays we are using 1200 cc engine with up to 3-cylinder engine. This is because of the engine downsizing. So ultimately we are using 3-cylinder engines in 1200 cc directly reduces engine weight as well as pumping losses from the crankshaft, as well as thermal loading, as well as better cooling system, better ignition systems, and most important parameter, vibration. Less vibration comes out from the engines. As we have less parameters, less components, so we are facing also less frictions and less vibration in our particular engine. So with the help of downsizing, these are the benefits we can get. So let us discuss types of engine downsizing technique. So first one is the using turbocharger. As I say, with the help of turbocharger, we can better density difference compared to the conventional engines. Second one is the using supercharger engines. And third one and most important parameters of the using twin charging engine, means we can use two turbo system compared to single turbo, and we can get maximum engine downsizing with the help of twin charge turbo system. Now, which are the methods we are going to use in particularly downsized engines? Because with the help of direct injection system, we can get directly downsizing with the help of these parameters like injection pressure, then spark plug intensity as well as fuel pump pressure. So we can get maximum pressure at the time of the combustion. Second stage is the EGR, exhaust gas recirculation system. With the help of exhaust gas recirculation system, we can also approach downside system. And third one is the variable wall timing body. With the help of variable wall lift mechanism, we can get maximum engine downsizing possibility. Right? So these are the main engine downsizing technique sometimes asked in GTU exams also. As you know, turbocharger how works, supercharger how works, and which are the function of twin charging in our automotive industry. You very well know about this, but this is the simple methods to achieve turbo downsizing system in our combustion process. Now, next thing is that which are the advantages behind the engine downsizing. So first one is the reduction in CO2 as well as NO2 emission, right? Obviously, we are using optimum parameters and we are using best efficient engines with the help of engine downsizing. So we can get less CO2 and NOx in our emission system. Second thing is that reduction in fuel consumption. Basically, downsized engines produce more power with compared to conventional engines, and also helpful in, you can say that also helpful in fuel economy of the engine. Third thing is the decrease in weight and reduce the vibration of the engines, as well as reduce the frictions, pumping losses of the engine. So we can get maximum possible output from the engine. Fourth one is the lesser sweat volume by the piston, right? We can optimize the piston volume and we can optimize also cubic capacity of the engine. So this is the main and basic advantage of the engine downsizing, right? And last one is the reducing pumping losses. See, when we decrease the engine cylinders numbers, at that time, same time, we also get the maximum benefit in pumping losses. So more pumping losses. So we can say that with the help of less reduced cylinders, we can get reducing pumping losses. So these are the main advantages behind the engine downsizing. First one is the emission reduction. Second is the lightweight capacity. Third one is the decrease in power to weight ratio, and last one is the pumping losses. Now, most important topic of the chapter is the selective catalyst reduction. So why it is important nowadays in our particular automobile system? Because see, government just launched a scrap policy, right? Why government launched scrap policy? Because of this particular emission standards, right? So we have very low emission standards compared to the international standards. So government nowadays implements scrap policy to demolish the all old vehicle up to 20 years and to upgrade the automotive sectors in upcoming standards. So which are the basic parameters and which are the basic we can say that methods to improve the emission standards. So selective catalyst reduction is the best method to improve the emission standards with the help of different types of we can say that different types of ammonia, and we can also say that basically ammonia and urea we are going to use in SCR system. So SCR directly reduce the emission of the engine coming out from the engine, right? So let us discuss SCR in detail. So which are the main emission pollutant in our engines is the NOx, right? So reduction of nitrogen oxide with liquefied ammonia or urea in the presence of catalyst. So this is the main purpose of the SCR process, which will be helpful to reduce NOx with the help of ammonia, liquid ammonia, or we can say that with the help of urea, we can directly minimize the nitrogen oxides coming out from the engines. Nowadays in our Ahmedabad, AMTS buses, BRTS buses directly use selective catalyst reduction in their buses, and they also get success in particular field to reduce the emission from the engine, because government have to follow these regulations according to BS6, and with the help of this selective catalyst reduction, we can minimize NOx particles coming down from the engines. Selective catalyst means what? Right. Selective catalyst means that the NH3 react directly with NOx particle only, instead of nitrogen, carbon dioxide or N2O. Right. Means why we can say that it is a selective catalyst? Because ammonia or urea directly chemically react with only NOx particle. That's why it is called a selective catalyst reduction. Right. And at the end of the process, right, which are the importance of this particular selective catalyst reduction? At the end of the process in selective catalyst reduction, we can get directly NOx into N2 and H2O, right, means nitrogen and water. So this is the main advantage of using urea and ammonia in particular system, right? So we can get directly nitrogen and water coming out from the engine. So this is the reason behind using SCR in our exhaust system, right? So in next lecture, we are going to discuss about basic process of the selective catalyst reduction, as well as advantages, disadvantages, limitations, and in this lecture, we are going to discuss about lean NOx trap. So how can we use lean system in particular emissions, and how can we reduce NOx particles coming out from the engines? Okay, thank you.